Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to another video on C programming language. In this video, we will write a simple C program to add all the values stored in an integer array and then we will display that result. Here, we will ask the user about how many values he wants to add. Then we will take the value entered by the user and depending on that value, we will create an array which can contain that many values. Then we will add all those array elements values and then we will display the result. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to create some variables. The first variable that we need will be for storing the array size, or we can say that number of values that the user wants to enter, and this will be our array size and the value will be an integer number, and the variable name that I'm going to give is numVal for number of values. And then we will ask the user about how many values he wants to add. So we will use a printf function and we will say how many values you want to add, and then whatever the value the user is going to enter, we will read that and we will store it in this numVal variable. So we will use a scanf function for that, and this will be %d for integer number, and we will store that in our numVal variable. Okay, now we know how many values the user wants to enter, or the array size. Now we are going to create our array. So the array will contain integer values. So the data type for the array is int, and let's give a name for the array. I'll call it as values, and the size of this array will be numVal, or the value stored in this numVal variable. Okay, now we have created an array. The next thing that we need to do is we need to ask the user about the numbers that he wants to add, or the values that he wants to add, and we will read that value and we will store that in this array values. So for that purpose we need a loop, and here we will use a for loop. And in this for loop, we need a counter variable, and I'm going to call it as loop counter. And this variable will point to the first element, second element, third element, like that. So we will use a for loop now, and the loop counter will start from zero. That's because the array indexing starts from zero. The first element will be at the index zero, and then this loop counter, so the number of values the user wants to enter is stored in this numVal variable. So here the condition will be loop counter is less than numVal. Here we have less than, that's because the loop counter is starting from zero. If it was starting from one, then we will have the condition less than or equal to here. Okay, and then after that we will increment the value of our loop counter variable so that with every iteration we can point to the next element of the array. So now we can display a message to the user saying that please enter the value %d, and here we will say loop counter plus 1. So here it will display like please enter the value 1, please enter the value 2, please enter the value 3, like that. Here the loop counter for the first iteration will contain 0. When we do loop counter plus 1, it will display 1 for the first iteration. And this statement here, which I have highlighted, is not altering the value of this loop counter variable. Okay, now the next thing is the user is going to enter the value, and what we are going to do is we are going to read that value and we will store that in this values array. We can directly read that value and we can store it in this values array, but I want to make this simple because this video is for the beginners. So I will create another variable here outside the for loop, and I will call it as value, which will contain each individual value entered by the user. So now after displaying the message about enter the value, we will read the value entered by the user and we will store that in this value variable first. So it's gonna be scanf function, and here %d format specifier, because we are reading an integer value, and we will store that in our value variable. Now here you can directly read that value to the marks array, but you know, we're gonna simplify this as much as possible. So after that, this value variable will contain the value entered by the user, and we will store that in our array. So we want to store that in this values array, and here the position where we want to store will be pointed by this loop counter variable equal to value. Okay, now here what we have done is we will ask the user to enter all that numbers that he wants to enter, and then we are reading those values and we are storing that in this array. Okay, now the next thing that we need to do is we need to calculate the sum of all these numbers which are in this array. So to store that value, we will create a variable and we will call it as result, and we will initialize that with a value of 0. Okay, now here we will loop through all the elements of the array and we will add that value to this result variable's value. Okay, so we need the for loop. So I'm gonna copy this for loop. I just don't want to type it again. Now here what we want to do is we want to add the array element's value to this result variable's value. So what we can do is result equal to result plus, now we need to refer to the array element, that will be values array, and the index will be in this loop counter variable. Okay, now here we are writing result equal to result plus values. If you want, you can simplify this and you can write result plus equal to values. Now that statement will be exactly equal to result plus values array and this index. So first result variable will contain a value of 0, and then the value stored in this first array element will be added to this result. So now the result variable will contain the value of the first element of the array, and then we will add all other elements value and we will store that in this result variable. Okay, now the last thing that we are going to do is we are going to display the result. So outside the for loop, I'm going to use a printf statement and I'm going to say result equal to %d, and here the result will be in this result variable. Okay, now we're going to build and run this. I just misspelled this printf, should be printf, and then we will correct that and build and run it. This time it says how many values you want to add. I'm gonna say 5 values. Enter the value 1 1, enter the value 2 2, enter the value 3 3 4 4 5 5. You can enter any values, and then if I hit the enter button, it says, so let's count this: 5 plus 4, which is 9, plus 3, which is 12, plus 2, which is 14, plus 1 is 15. So the result is proper. Now if you want, you can run this program many times and give different values. Okay, now you have to make a simple modification to this code, and that is, I said that you can directly store the value read from the user in this values array. You don't have to use this value variable separately. So you have to make that modification and you need to post that code in the comment section. I will look at your code and I will say whether it is right or wrong. So try that out, and if you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to watch more tutorials, then do subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later in the next video.